Hello my cuties! Welcome back to the All You Can Face YouTube channel. Today I would love to talk about retinol, or also known as vitamin A. Why is it good for you? What can it do for your skin, for your health? And what is my personal journey with retinol? Because I can tell you one or two things which might surprise you in that video. Retinol is overly known as an anti-aging product. It supposedly smooths fine lines, gets rid of acne, and brightens up your skin. But it has also quite a few side effects, which we'll dive deep into later. So retinol was discovered in 1909, and Harry Holmes and Ruth Corbett first crystallized it in 1937. 30 years later, in 1971, Dr. Klingman at University of Pennsylvania discovered retinoic acid to treat acne. And then Johnson & Johnson came along and marketed it as Retin-A and as an acne product, and it's still on the market today, 35 years later, and it's an amazing and effective way to treat acne. But enough for the history. What can you actually eat in order to get vitamin A naturally into your body? So amazing dietary sources of vitamin A contain, for example, cheese, milk, yogurt, dark green leafy vegetables, liver and liver products such as liver pate. You can also get an amazing dose of vitamin A into your body by eating beta carotene, which then transfers into retinol in your body. And this, for example, are your yellow and red and dark green leafy vegetables. For example, spinach, carrots, sweet potatoes, or red peppers. Yellow fruits such as mango, papaya, and apricots are also amazing and rich in beta carotene, which then transfers into retinol. How much vitamin A do you actually need? So the total vitamin A content of food is usually expressed in micrograms of retinol equivalent. And the average dose of vitamin A for adults between 19 and 64 is, for example, for males around 700 grams and for females 600 grams. You actually should get all the vitamin A from your diet. And the cool thing is, any vitamin A which is not used in your body is stored, so you do not have to eat it every day. Retinol is a derivative of vitamin A, and there are three forms of that derivative: retinol, retinal, and retinoic acid. And many tissues in our body actually require vitamin A, and it acts as an amazing antioxidant for our body. So now let's get into retinol in skincare. Remember I mentioned Dr. Klingman, who discovered retinoic acid, and his early patients got prescribed Retin-A, and they said that they experienced lesser wrinkles, smoother appearance of their skin, and reduced pigmentation. Dr. Klingman actually coined the phrase photoaging. That means that chronic sun exposure can lead to skin damage. In 1996, with Johnson & Johnson, he developed a product called Renova, which was supposedly help with photoaging. Tretinoin is actually an amazing way to get rid of acne, fine lines, and wrinkles, but it also has crazy side effects. It can irritate your skin, it can make it really sensitive to the sun, and it's only prescription only when it comes to the US and Europe. Retinol, on the other side, is a little bit less intense, but it also depends on the dose. It usually ranges from 0.1% to 1%. So retinol is generally tolerated better by the skin, and it also doesn't need any prescription. So retinol actually has similar benefits as tretinoin, such as getting rid of acne, wrinkles, texture in your skin, and pigmentation. So how does retinol actually work? It basically breaks down into retinoic acid when it has contact with your skin, and therefore increases cell turnover and boosts collagen production. Benefits will also only occur if you use it regularly over a longer period of time. So do not despair if you don't see any change after a couple of days or even weeks sometimes when starting your retinol journey. But it actually is basically suitable for all skin types, except if you're prone to super dry skin, eczema, because then your skin barrier is already compromised and you shouldn't irritate it even further. how to use retinoids and how to introduce them into your skincare regime and when to start. So you should start probably when you are in your mid-20s, when you feel like your collagen production slowly but surely slows down, you see your first fine lines and wrinkles. You can absolutely introduce retinol or vitamin A products into your skincare regime. The best way is actually to consult your dermatologist, because there you can discuss your entire journey, the percentage, what product is best for you. And sometimes it can even help to start earlier, maybe in your teens even, but this needs to be supervised by a professional doctor, obviously. How much should you use actually when starting retinol or in general? Always use a pea-sized amount. I'm usually the one who loves to lather skincare on their face, and with retinol or vitamin A products, you should be really, really careful, and you do not need to use a lot in order to see results. So always use a pea-sized amount. I put it onto my finger and then I always like dab a little bit and then tap it onto my forehead around here, and then really like just spread it around until I have nothing on my finger left, and then evenly distribute it over my face. When you start your journey, put it onto your face and look how your skin reacts after 3 to 4 days, because you might not see in any reaction on the next day, but the pilling and the redness can actually occur a couple of days later. So be patient and use it. Look how your skin reacts after 3 to 4 days, and then continue using it every 3 to 4 days. And if you feel like your skin can tolerate it enough, then make the intervals a little bit smaller and introduce it every 2 days. And if you're really a retinol pro, you can even use it every day. But this needs time and patience. And patience is a big word here, because it can take up to 3 months to see your first results when it comes to retinol. So try to be really patient. Try also go through this thing called purging, which is basically, when you start introducing retinol into your skincare regime, then your cell turnover obviously increases. And then all these things are coming out as pimples, as all kinds of things you do not want to have on your skin, and you might freak out and you think this is obviously the retinol causing it. But this should actually go away after a couple of days or weeks. Because imagine like a glass with a little bit of dirt on it. If you start shaking it, everything pops up. But because everything was dormant underneath, it pops up, and in the best way usually goes out of your skin, maybe through also your lymphatic system, lymphatic drainage, and you will be left with better skin afterwards. So absolutely be patient and probably consider 3 months to see your first amazing results with retinol. Another thing which is really important, use your retinol always at night, because first of all, it's very sun sensitive, and obviously you do not want to irritate the skin further by exposing it to the sun and having retinol on. And lastly, retinol actually loses its potency when used throughout the daytime. And the really, really most important thing I preach in probably all of my skincare videos is to use SPF. And especially with retinol, you should use SPF on daily basis, because even if you sometimes do not use retinol or on the days you are not using it, the skin absolutely becomes a little bit more prone to sun damage. It becomes more sensitive to sun. So overall, SPF should be a staple in your skincare routine, but especially with retinol, that should be the case. And when it comes to mixing retinol with other active ingredients, I would avoid that. To be honest, start with retinol on its own, also to observe how it truly reacts on your skin, rather than mixing it with, for example, vitamin C, which you should absolutely not do. You can use an hyaluronic acid with it to hydrate the skin, but that is about it. I have an entire video about active ingredients, so have a look, because I touch upon that topic even further. So yeah, with retinol, the easiest way is actually to stay off other active ingredients. And now lastly, I want to talk about my personal experience with vitamin A, with retinol, because all the dermatologists out there, which you also see on social media, they love retinol. And I can see why, because it has a lot of medical studies behind it. There are people raving about it, and I see people having glass skin after using it for years. But to be honest, I used retinol, or actually isotretinoin, orally when my acne was at its peak and it was just crazy and it absolutely helped me. But the side effects are crazy. You need to go on a monthly basis to a doctor to get not only blood tests done to see how everything is functioning in your body with taking that drug, and also doing pregnancy tests, because one of the craziest side effects when using vitamin A or is a tretinoin is that the fetus, due to the vitamin A, can be completely damaged, and you should absolutely not get pregnant when using it. And now I'm in my 30s, and I just recently actually went to Mexico, and I went into a pharmacy as I always do because I love to see new products and test out new things. And I found that they have the Retin-A cream. I've tried out all kinds of different retinol products and it just didn't do anything for me. Or maybe I wasn't patient enough, but it just irritated my skin. I felt worse than before, and yeah, I just stayed off it. So I wanted to give it actually a chance. 4 months ago, I bought this cream and started it. And I started with, as I said, every 4 days. And then I enhanced it after a month into every 3 days. And I observed my skin, and to be honest, my skin started to become super flaky. Everything came out, as I said, when it came to purging. I have actually a picture here how I looked when I purged. And now, being 4 months into it, I have to say, yes, my skin improved. But I think the side effects for me personally were not worth it to go through this entire purging process and also damaging my skin. And if you look at it, and let me pull this up, it got me thinking, it has so many crazy side effects. Why would you put it onto your face on daily basis? I know it will make your skin smooth and extremely beautiful, but what is the price for that? I do think there are other alternatives out there. I, for example, love to use glycolic acid or AHAs and BHAs to exfoliate my skin, use sun protection on daily basis. Overall, use ingredients which are less harmful and do not have such side effects as retinol. So with that being said, I wanted also to tell you my side of the story and why I'm probably not going to use this for any longer. I sometimes do use it, but between us, there are way much more amazing ingredients out there, which I will touch upon in another video, because I think this is really, really important to look into alternatives. And I think also purging and redness and flakiness and irritation should not be part of a healthy skincare journey. And that's my personal opinion. If you want to go there, you know now the pros and cons with retinol or vitamin A. So be your own judge. And again, it's your body, your skin, but know at least what implication it can have. And with that being said, I thank you for sticking through this video with me, and I hope you learned one or two things. If you have any questions in terms of skincare ingredients or especially retinol, leave them in the comments below, or share your own vitamin A journey with me. I would love to hear it. And yeah, make sure to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and I can't wait to see you next week for the next All You Can Face YouTube video. Mwah!